What do you think about brand versus Lifang? I think pure menagerie, like I had, Lifang's actually better now. Like pure menagerie, where you have like five different tribes. But I think if you have like three Murlocs or like three mechs and then one other unit, it's just better to go Baran. But pure menagerie, I actually think Lifang might be better now. I hate when I play well, get decent luck, and get smashed by seven or eight high rollers. It's just part of the game, though. It's the way it is. You think it's appropriate better that Lifang is better for full menagerie? Yeah, it's good. I think Lifang doesn't feel oppressive to me. I don't know about you guys. It feels like, I mean, it feels like a good unit to hit. Like, it's obviously strong, and the game does revolve around five drops, but I still feel like it's not like an oppressive thing. Almost nothing feels oppressive at the moment. Yeah, actually, everything feels pretty balanced this time, right? What do you guys think is the biggest problem? I don't really have that big of an issue with anything. I just think they need to fix a few units and then they're good. Like Junkbot is a piece of shit. Maybe Siegebreaker could be buffed like a tiny bit in stats. Demons are still terrible. They're okay. They're playable. Oh yeah, they need to fix six drops a little bit for elementals. They're really bad for elementals. Yeah, Galakrond needs a slight nerf as well. And I agree, Jandis is too good with both tokens. Yep. Nomi doesn't feel oppressive at all. I think just the six drops for elementals do need to be fixed though. Like the six drops are so shitty for elementals. Taking 25 from turn 5 from a random gas coil is pretty stupid. I mean, that's just the game. Is this worth it? Probably not, right? Fuck it. I'm YOLOing it. Let's lose. About to take a lot of damage. About to take 2 plus 2 plus 2, 7 damage here. That's good. I'll take it. Sensei would be the nuts, but it's all good. Would Gallop be more balanced if you couldn't freeze on the turns you hero power it? Yeah, it'd be really good. Or really, it'd make him a lot worse. You think Jandis would be balanced if she wasn't on the hero rotation when both tokens are available? Yeah, she would be super balanced. She's a little bit too strong with both tokens, but at high MMR, I feel like it's not a problem at lower MMR, probably. But yeah, I mean, I feel like that's like kind of excusable, though. I might actually tie this, huh? Do. Want it? Got lucky with that first hit. Sensei? Hell yeah. Don't want the bomb? Not really. I want to sell this, but I can't, so. What's the best, Stuart? Jandis with one token in the game, Murloc. You guys think I'm gonna win the flip? Why not Salty? There's almost no chance I go mid-range Pirates. Why not buy the bomb? Because I don't really want Sensei to have multiple targets to buff. You generally want to, have it buff one or two. 3-4 is better than 4-4. I mean, I can sell it to buff something else, so that's what makes it better. This guy's very strong. Close.
mean, I know I never go midrange pirate, so I don't pick up the pirate. There. Shit. This is fun. Level. I should level here always. Hero power, the selfless of the harvest. Probably the selfless at this point. Is George good with no murlocs? He's fine. Why should I always level here? What I'm rolling for is pretty, like, I can't really hit that much rolling on three because I'm only looking for like Sensei and Deflecto and Menace. And I guess bronze is okay. But on four, every time I roll, I get to see five units as opposed to four. So each roll is 20% better already, or 25% better. And I'm also looking for egg and module and increase my hits a lot. I can even take like scale bin and stuff. It's just, it's worth taking the hit here for the level, even if I take like 10. Also, I do want to sell this bronze, this Stuart for something better. So yeah, we'll see. I missed that, but it actually might be more beneficial this way to reduce damage. He's pretty strong. Oh man, did he murder that one? Oh, that was the best hit for him. R.I.P. I think I lose this. As long as I don't take too much damage. It looks like these hits are pretty bad, though. It looks like a loss. Not the worst loss, though. Considering I leveled, 5 is great, or 4 is great. There, perfect. This is a good turn to sell it, I guess. Do I even buy this? Or do I roll past it? Just buy it to get strong, I guess. I probably... Hank? Oh yeah, Hank's probably better. Egg is great. Alright, we're strong. I can sell this. Hopefully it doesn't buff this. If it doesn't buff it, then I can sell it. If it does, I'm in trouble. How you doing, kitty? How's it going?
Oh, look, she's barking. Oh, she's barking. Oh, good girl. Hi, Phillips.
I want another reset here. Nice. I can sell this off, finally. The clanker is gone. Oh, he has an Amalgadon Munkus. Wow. Pretty absurdly strong, actually. At least the Amalgadon is dead. Should be okay. We're fine. Okay. I mean, we're really strong also, so it's... Just have to get this Deflecto up and look for modules and senseis and crap, and we're good. Need to sell this. Or I could find the triple poggers. Should I even take this? I might just have to roll for something better. I don't really like it. Trash. Menace is good. No time for doing anything. That's so good. Fuck, I want that. Alright, we just have to not miss here. Just don't miss the buff, Smile. The reason why I didn't want to take the 2-5 there is because I was planning on selling this for another unit anyways. So I wanted to make sure that I had space for it, if that makes any sense. Kind of weird, but yeah. Would I ever hero power another mech to have another reset? I did that on this one, but it's fine. I don't really care. Maybe once I have 2 deflectos. I'm probably going to roll one more time on this level, or am I leveling? Actually, my level... It's hard to say. Maybe I roll again, try to go for a triple... I could pick up like a hangry pair or something. Nice, I hit it. Lucky. We're pretty strong though. We have a good setup for sure. It's just turn 8, we don't have a win condition. We're just mechs. So this is at least top 4, but yeah. Why do I always put Menace on Deflecto? I already have a reset here. And if you put it on the Deflecto, then the other Deflecto that I'm gonna buy, it has redundancy. So if one Deflecto dies, the other one gets buffed, as opposed to like one dying and then the other one dying. So the odds become a lot better for your fight. It's all about the redundancy for it. I took it. And it boosts the damage for it. I think I'm going to stay on this level one more turn here. Trash. Oh, I can buy the hangry, actually. I'm probably going to keep the hangry. That's good. I want to module the sensei, right? I don't want to module the egg, right? Am I going to be able to keep the sensei, though? I don't want this. This is going to be gone soon. This makes my resets kind of bad. Spot about module on the egg. You want it? You want one separate and one on it. I guess I could hero power the egg, yeah. This depends how long I'm keeping this for. I don't know. This is, like, better for now, but I'm just not sure if it's better overall. Because it's gonna depend on, you usually want the reset separate. I'm just thinking about what I do. Isn't there a chance you waste your hero power with module and egg? Yeah, that's why I didn't really want to do it also. But it's fine because I just put a bumper up front because I have so many death rattles. So it doesn't really matter here. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, my setup is fine. I'm just not scaling well enough for me to feel comfortable about winning this game. As I said, it's definitely like a top four situation unless I get high rolled out of this game. But another module... pretty good, actually. But then I don't have any more space. I could, like, sell this, put the module here, and then buy the scale bane. What if just double scale bane and sell this? Try to go dragon after? I have two pairs. That's pretty good. I think it might be okay. This doesn't really do anything. I have to do this. I could even keep this, but I think I'd sell it. Just want the divine shield crap up. I don't know. It's like kind of an awkward spot to be in because I'm probably going to have to sell a scale bane. So maybe I wasted my entire turn there. I'm basically banking on the fact that I'm going to hit a triple this way, which I don't really like, but... three pairs, yeah. I might even combine the deflectors at this point, because the second one's so shitty. I'll take egg pairs. I don't know what else. That has a worse buff. It's fine. It's pretty strong. It's fine. Oh. I'm not going to get a second reset on this. I mean, that's fine. I didn't get another egg. That was a weird case where my guy didn't die. I think we still win this fight, question mark. We still win it. Oh, he took it. Definitely doesn't have another loss. 74% win. So I'm at 11, or turn 11. It's all trash. Leaper's too good. Egg pair's fine. Light Fang? Not quite with my build. Trash and trash. So we'll sit one more turn here. I hope things pan out. Pair gamer. Yeah. Probably lose this fight. We'll see how it pans out. Hangry value. He's a well-fed boy. If I find a Kangor, I can actually go Death Rattle build here. Can hero power reborn the Kangor. It's pretty good. See ideal 6 drop. Amalgadon, but it's really unlikely to hit. What do you think would be done to make Junk Pot viable? 4-drop. Psy Guy, thank you for the prime. He'd be pretty playable at 4. He'd be kind of strong at 4. Okay, stop buffing that. That one's a good one buff. Just not that one. Look at that Foe Reaper, dude. It's a good buff for me there. We didn't hit that. I don't even get the Reborn there. I'm not gonna die, but I'm definitely gonna take it here. Definitely taking it. Actually, I can kill that one. I don't take it. I'm not taking it. 50-50 fight there. He has a Bran and a big Foe Reaper. Like, just don't really stand a chance against people who drew scaling units. I didn't level early enough to get one, so there's that problem. Shit, Elise is gonna stomp me. I beat Elise. Oh, this is good. Should play, actually I can play this first because of this. Kali. Nadina or Kangor. Probably Kangor and reborn him. Let's roll. And Zephyr hit 5 triples. It's not a good sign. I don't know. I don't have any health is my problem. So, things need to go well. First place? I don't think I'm that strong. If I had an upgraded egg, I'd feel a little more confident. Right now, I don't feel that strong. He's weak. He's pretty weak. Should be fine. It's like nothing. We have too much damage for him here. We have him covered like everywhere in terms of damage. He's attacking to one of my mechs. There we go. Taking to Mexico. Well, that was bad, though. I mean, we still beat him. It's just we don't kill him here. I wanted to kill him. 41% lethal. I can fight the dead guy. It'd be nice. Nice. So now the decision. Do I want to level or do I want to roll? The problem is, if I level, hitting in a Balgadon doesn't even really work that well. Especially with this. But I guess I still level for another Kangor or something. I don't know. It doesn't really matter what I do here. There's no point to level, but there's no point in not leveling. You know what I mean? Baron. Baron's not even good. I think I just have to hit this. I'm just going to take some buffs and replace this for the end. I'll sell this at the very end, and then we'll just buy a bunch of buffs. It's fine. I don't think leveling does anything. I'm, like, thinking about it. Well, for Bran, I don't even think I want a Bran. I don't have a space for Bran. Ever combine Deflecto? No, never. I really want to buff this Deflecto's health to 5. It being a 3 makes it die to, like, anything. Hey, kitty. You love Chubbs? What about me? Scammed. Taunt the Deflectos. You don't really want to be taunting Deflectos unless everything has Death Rattle. Don't think it's really worth it. It's more of a desperation move to do it. You only do it if you feel like you're incredibly far behind in the fight. And you need stuff to go your way. Galakrond beat Elise. That's not good. Don't want any of this crap. Oh, hello. Buy this one first. Buy Bran. Sell this. Foe Reaper. I mean, I don't want anything else. Should I roll first? Try to find another buffer? Probably. I don't get another buffer now. Minus 250k from Kazupo. So to save my points for over a year, finally have enough. Now I can tell dog that his... That my what? These all suck. I get one more roll. Nothing. What's the best here? Probably Admiral. Hit a big Foe Reaper. I can't really play around it, can I? So this pans out.
It's okay.
It's gonna come down to the this is really bad actually, because I lose this. I got a Foe Reaper back and a Deflecto, but that's pretty bad. I don't get anything else back aside from that. The Red Whelp, the real MVP of the game. Should be fine. Foe Reaper was scary. We're big and chonky. We are big and chonky. You're not wrong about that one. I mean, I don't really want anything here. I need something to replace this, I guess. Spore? Spore is probably the best I'm gonna get. So buff this one. Should be good. You guys like my comp? It's beautiful! Reborn Spore, and this makes it better for my Deflectos. My Deflectos are my damage, not my Spore. Maybe I do this actually, though. Ghoul kill Spore? That is a great observation. Great. Does Ghoul completely kill me? No, Ghoul only kills one of the Deflectos. It doesn't completely kill me. Talk of the Tavern. Well, the game is over. Is that a good achievement or a bad achievement? Does anyone know? It's probably a good achievement. Things are going my way, it looks like. That's a golden boat. Uh-oh. I can't tell what's going on. Smile. I think we're fine. Absolutely slaughtered. 67%. I mean, it was definitely a hero power that Kangar, right? Kangar was very strong. Syndromic, thank you for the 44 months. Easy.